A lot of the information we encounter on a daily basis is visual. So a lot of the misinformation we encounter is also visual. Images are one example. Images can be manipulated, used deceptively. Often things that look real are photoshopped. Sometimes things that look photoshopped are real. In context, photos are miscaptioned and missummarized constantly. It's practically a web tradition. Now, the good news is with a few simple steps, you can often find the photo in its original context and understand the meaning of the photo yourself. So let me show you some quick steps to do this. First, let's look at this photo. It went viral back in March. It's a dolphin and some fish swimming in the water, which might make a nice photo on its own, but it's accompanied by a pretty shocking claim. The water of Venice has become so clear from the coronavirus lockdown, this person claims, at least, that the dolphins have returned to the canals for the first time in 60 years. Now, there's been lots of images and posts making similar claims. Maybe you've seen some of these, the phrase, nature is healing. And a lot of the images and claims are true, but is this one real or fake? Now, we could spend all day staring at this photo and trying to figure out if it's been Photoshopped, but instead, I'm going to show you a quick trick that will help us figure out if, A, the photo is real, and B, if it's showing what it claims to show. And as you'll see in a moment, these are really two separate but equally important questions. Now, just like we did with text, we can search images in Google to get additional context. We just right-click on the image and select search Google for image. If you're using a mobile device, just press the image and hold and select search Google for image. Now, in this case, we get lucky, sort of, right? There's lots of stories here that seem to repeat this claim, but the most credible source on the page, National Geographic, a magazine and a society that looks at precisely these sorts of stories, seems to feature the photograph in a story that implies this is false. So we click on the article, we use our CTRL-F to quickly search for dolphin and see if we can learn more about this image. In this case, we learn that the photos are real, but they weren't taken in Venice. Reading further, we can see that the reporter's already done the hard work for us. They've traced these images back to their source. Often when images go viral, we can count on professional journalists and fact checkers to do the work of establishing proper context for us. And that turns out to be the situation here. Once in a while, though, you'll have to do the work yourself. For example, here's a photo from an anti-lockdown protest showing protesters holding signs that say things like defund science, defend my right to die. And again, we could spend hours debating whether this image was photoshopped and staring at the pixels, or we can do a quick search and see if we can learn more about the source of this image. For this example, we'll use a site called TinEye. TinEye works in every browser. It's a good alternative if you're not using Chrome. In this case, we can right-click the image, select copy image address, and then we go to TinEye, we right-click on the toolbar, press paste, and hit return. Here we see a list of other places where this image has appeared. Now, look at this, Snopes. Snopes is already up at the top with an article from yesterday. This is actually new from last time I looked at it, but we could do this even if Snopes wasn't there yet. We see that NBC News, a reputable organization, has used the image recently, and we click into the NBC News link. It brings us to a story from April 20 about how Facebook has been removing events, and here's our photo right at the top with a caption giving us the original context. Protest, Colorado, April 19th. So the photo is from a protest, but notice that the content of the signs is not what was in the photo from the tweet. The photo in the tweet was Photoshopped, but we figured that out by using some simple tricks to find the original source, not by doing pixel-level analysis, not by looking for signs of manipulation.